Kumusta naman ang mga relationships ninyo ngayong panahon ng pandemic? Nag-improve ba o lumala? Yung iba siguro sabi, lumala ram kasi araw-araw ko nakikita. Kasi naka-work from home. I hope hindi po ganyan ang mga relationships nyo ngayon, ha? And hello, good morning everyone. Welcome to 5 Minutes with Kuya Ram. If I'm going to ask you, how can you make your relationship a win-win situation? And madali bang gawin? Mahirap, di ba? Lalo na kung yung kasama mo, medyo hindi kagandahan ang ugali. And you know what? If your only motive for giving to someone is to see what you can get back, you will be disappointed. Madi-disappoint ka lang, pre. Kasi di ba na-experience mo to, baka yung iba sa inyo ganito karamihan. Di ba pag Pasko, pag nagbibigay ka ng regalo na yung medyo mamahalin or nakabalot pa sa malaking kahon, bakit? Para magmukhang malaki. Bakit? Kasi ang intention mo, dapat mas malaking ibigay nito or mas mamahalin. Ganun ba ang karamihan sa inyo? Umamin po kayo, huwag kayong magsisinungaling. Di ba natutunan natin last 2 weeks? Kung napanood mo yung video, o hindi mo pa po napanood, mamaya balikan mo po after mo mapanood ito. Yung video ko about why we need to think more about others. Di ba sabi ng Bible, let each of you look out not only for his own interests, but also for the interests of others. When you give yourself to another person, for that person's development and well-being, you are truly giving, and God will bless you for it. Wow! So if you're married or a parent, di ba, you know this from personal experience. What does your husband or wife value most highly? Money in the bank or your time freely given? And what would your children rather have? A toy or your undivided attention? You know what? The people who love you would rather have you than what you can give them. It's wise to invest in yourself and your career, but never at the expense of those who matter most. And listen to this. If you succeed in your career but fail with your loved ones, your success will be hollow and your regrets will be real. Kaya nga matuto tayo sa isa sa pinakamatalinong taong nabuhay at itago natin siya sa pangalan na Solomon. Solomon was famous for his wealth and wisdom. Yet, itong sabi niya sa Ecclesiastes chapter 2 verse 11, it says, as I looked at everything I had worked so hard to accomplish, it was also meaningless, like chasing the wind. Wow! Grabe, no? Imagine, lahat daw meaningless or walang kwenta, pre. So let's learn from his mistakes. So don't invest in things, but invest in relationships. And here is how most relationships often play out. Pakinggan nyo, ha? I win, you lose, I win only once. You win, I lose, you win only once. We both win, we win many times. So as I end, here is my takeaway sa inyong lahat. When you seek the good of others, God promises that good things will come to you. So I hope I was able to share new truths and principles sa inyo ngayon. And if may natutunan po kayo, please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button kung first time mo po sa aking channel sa mga hindi pa subscribers. And pati na rin po yung notification bell para ma-notify po kayo sa mga future videos ko. So magkita-kita po ulit tayo next week. Dito lang ulit sa channel ni Kuya Ram. So God bless you and thank you for watching.